So when did you start with me, Gladys?
It had to be 30 years ago.
30 years ago, but I'm only 45.
Oh, no.
Gladys, this sounds corny, but this is the secret, resistance. Just show us a couple exercises.
Okay. I'll show you what I do every day.
Triceps, tightening up the back of the arms. Okay, that's good.
Okay. Just lifting.
Firming the shoulders.
Yes.
Tightening the arms. I have not seen Gladys for how many years in person?
Oh, long time.
Many years, and when I just met her, and the elevator opened and I saw her there, I was motivated. I was inspired because she looked so good. So, you know, she could have been coming in with a cane or a wheelchair, and she's just standing there looking sort of sassy, you know, and looking great. So you're the new breed. You're the new generation. You're fit, not feeble. And you know, Bill almost lost for life. He almost lost for life. What did you eat to almost lose for life?
I told you, you know, bologna sandwiches and all the good things, you know, like eggs, whole milk, ice cream, red meat, and damn near killed me.
How about the cheese?
Oh, lots of cheese. I love cheese. Okay. I'm a big cheese eater.
So the thing is that if you're, see, it's really simple. You have certain lifestyle or way of life, certain things that you're losing life, and certain things you're winning life. So if you just eliminate the losing life and do, now Bill is jogging, and what is your activity now? And tell him about the... What happened because of your eating habits?
Well, my first heart attack was in 88, and I went on a, not a diet, but I changed my eating habits, but I think the harm was already done. It set in, and I had another one in just last April.
Oh, I hope this hasn't been too dull. Do I still need this mic?
Stephen Bruce is over there going, how am I going to follow this act?
Oh, no. Gladys, come here a second. You said follow the act.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, he told me that he would do push-ups with her on his back.
What do you feet apart?
And we're on live cable, dear. Don't worry about it. Here went another 16-year career down the drain.
Still here.
This tape may be worth something. It might be the last show I've ever been able to do.
I will.
Okay. Watch it.
Would the audience please count with me? It helps motivation.
Okay. Loud. One. Come on.
Two.
Come on, Doc. Go.
Three.
Come on.
Four.
Yeah.
Five.
Yeah, let's hey. Woo! First name.
This is Peter.
Peter, and where are you calling from?
I'm calling from the control room.
Do you have a question, sir, for our guests?
Yeah, I got a question for you. My father is kind of getting up there. He's 81. He used to do an awful lot of walking around and you know, was really keeping in good shape. But lately he just isn't, you know, doing as much in the way of physical fitness as he was. He just sort of seems to have lost the spirit of it. Anything you can suggest to kind of have me motivate him to get out and do it again? I know he can.
I could give a one-hour sermon on that, but here's the bottom line. You said the key word, he used to. That's called a youster. Once you're a youster and you stop doing these things, you're dying. Remember, I said you're regenerating like Gladys by keeping active mind, spirit, body, or you're degenerating. Beach was the birthplace. Then UCLA and USC in a physical therapy school. I went to college for 10 years. Started the Jacqueline Hill Spas. And
Hi, welcome to City Watch Live. Your first name?
Susan.
Yes. All right. You got a question?
I've got a question for Dr. Nguyen.
Okay.
I wanted to find out, are different people on different time clocks? Like some people exercise in the morning and they wake up, and other people get sick in the morning if they exercise?
Okay. Now, I'll cover that as briefly as possible. Number one, when you wake up in the morning, you're depressed. You have to be depressed or you'd be awake all night. So your system has to slow down, your pulse has to slow down, your heart. So in the day, it's fine. But remember, if you increase your metabolism in the morning, your metabolism will be greater all day long, and you'll be burning calories all day long, and have less chance of gaining fat. So it is physiologically best in the morning, but what I say is this. Doing any type of physical activity, Do something is better than nothing. Walking is the most important exercise, because when you can't walk, you're an invalid, you're a cripple, you're finished. So keep walking, and I like walking up hills also, or up a treadmill for resistance. Walking is the most important thing, and I like to give you one statistic, and that is that the average person spends the last 11.4 years of their life as an invalid or a cripple. That's from the U.S. Department of Health. Trick?
We've got about a minute. How much time we got, Mr. Information?
I'm going to do a one-hand handstand on your head. How much time do we have? Oh, we don't have enough time.
Thank you. Sit down. I got a question. According to the U.S. Census Bureau, in 1990, there were 78 million seniors, or approximately 31% of the United States population. And by the year 2010, there will be 118 million seniors, or approximately 42% of the U.S. population. I might be one of those seniors. Yikes, it's a tremendous medical cost if we don't exercise.
The bottom line, I'd like to just make one more statement, and that is that life is your most precious possession.
Yeah.
Life insurance is really death insurance. And the healthcare crisis is really an illness crisis. But the key is to win for life. Now, I didn't say win for life, and I didn't say win for life. I said win for life. So let's everybody say, win for life.
Win for life.
Zen Dr. Win, you are incredible.
Here we have the world's best developed man, natural, no steroids, no junk. Woo, oh, awesome. Look at that, the deltoids. Now, this is important for the women to do because it pulls your shoulders back and it makes the bust line look better. Oh, Jiminy. I guess there's not much to say. Awesome. The middle pecs. See the, and with the women, since the pecs support the bust line, it lifts the bust line naturally. Now he's getting the deltoid and the lats. This is anatomy, kinesiology. How many exercises can you do on this?
Probably like 700.
See, it's actually infinite because each angle works the muscles differently. Every time you move it, that's different from that. And every time he moves it, it's a different exercise. Could you make it like one, put it on four maybe, just to show how you adjust it? So what is it, heavier now? What is it, what number?
Pretty much.
What number is it?
This is number four.
Number four. Could you do the delts once over the head? Oh boy. Now that's lifting the upper bust line. It just lifts the bust line up. Two-way resistance. In other words, you get resistance as you go in, in, out. Two-way resistance. So they're getting the back muscles and the chest muscles. How about the forearms, do you do? Watch this one, the forearms. See that working? We need super Americans, super Americans, super Americans. When there's a problem, the super Americans attack and they win. Win, yay, win, and whatever you do, win, yay, win. It's the measure of you. Win, Jim.
The best gym ever developed.